Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this project taken from my CorelDRAW 2019 training course, I'll be showing you how to make a business card based upon the business card templates that come with CorelDRAW. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share and subscribe. I put up lots of videos each week. There's my current schedule, and I'll also be putting in some videos in the in-between days as well. Don't forget to take a look at my complete training course for CorelDRAW, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. We'll start off with a brand new template. I'm on the Getting Started tab right here, as you can see there. We'll ignore all this stuff and go up to File, come down to New from Template. Now in here, I have this set at Business Cards. And we'll start off with this card right there. The nice thing about working with a business card as a starting point is it gives you the basic page size already. It gives you all the standard stuff that you'll need to have, you know, the name, address, phone number, that kind of stuff. Let's just click on this business card right here. As soon as you see it over on the right-hand side, and of course I have my show details checked right down there, click open, it then opens that up. And again, what this does for you is it gives you the business card sized page already taken care of, and your basic text is in here. You, of course, can change all this stuff as you go, but it's nice to have it set up ahead of time just to save you some effort. Let's now get rid of the stuff that we don't need, like these top color bar here. I'm just going to pull a selection marquee around that. There we go. Hit the delete key. Let's click on this object, hit the delete key here, click on that one and the delete key as well. We'll leave all this as is for the moment and bring in our basic content. The first thing I want to bring in is a graphic over here for the house. Now I still have my connect content available up over here on the right hand side. If you don't have that, just go up to the window menu and come down to Dockers and connect content right there. And of course we've already imported a whole batch of content in here. So be using that. Click on the business section. Give this a chance to load in. There we go. If you scroll down a little bit, you'll find kind of a nice building with a real estate sign out front. And I'll use the scroll wheel here just to speed things up a little bit. And it's right down here. Once you have located your graphic, you can do a right click and just import that. There you go. Or you could just drag it and drop over onto the page as well. It comes in at the full size. We'll need to resize this. Let's just close this down or kind of minimize that. And that's that little arrow again right here, little double arrow. Now to minimize this, I'm going to roll backwards on the mouse wheel and zoom out just a little bit. You see the outline right there, that is our page, and then our document here. Our object is far too large, of course. I'm just going to grab a corner and let's pull this in, make it a lot smaller, and pull it a lot smaller again. And then using the wheel on the mouse again, roll back in. Pretty close right now. If it goes all white like that on you, just adjust your zoom. It will go back to correct again. Bring it on even further. Around here someplace is about right. Now, as you can see, it has a white background and it's sitting on top of our text. We don't want that, so let's change our positioning for this, the stacking order. Notice that we're still selected, so right click, and then where it says order, just send to the back of the page. It's now in behind the text, and I'll pull it up here just a little bit. Let's come down to our text. I clicked off or outside here just to deselect that, and here's our top text. If you just triple click 1, 2, 3, it gives you your selection right there. We can then just retype this, and this is real, all caps. Come down to our next line here. Again, triple click and then put that in as all caps as well. I'm leaving the positions the same. It just happens to work out fine. Back to our pick tool up here and back to the house. We can now bring this down just a little bit. Hit it to fit in that little gap. Now you can use the up and down, left and right arrows on your keyboard and your keypad here to really get this exactly where you want it, but somewhere around in there is pretty good. Now the next problem on this, I'm going to go just a little bit smaller, I think. There we go. Our next problem is we want to have this in blue and not in black. So it's a collection of objects, a lot of different graphics. So it's a triangle here, and here's a rectangle, a couple of rectangles in there, a couple of dots, and so forth. So it's a collection of objects that are grouped together. I'm going to right-click on this, and up here we have ungroup. And the reason I want to ungroup is I want to be able to colorize just the lines in here. If I try colorizing this as it is right now, click on the blue over here, the whole thing goes blue like that. We can now just use our undo button. Let's right-click and ungroup all. And we now should have this as individual objects. I'm going to click outside first and then click back inside. And as you can see right now, I have just the house selected. See the little control dots in there. And click on the blue, and that changes that color. We'll now come through and click on each individual object. Little door handles right there, or dots. And then over in here on the sign. There we go. And the rest of the sign. So we've now changed all of this to that blue color. If you want to have this as a group again, just come outside here someplace and drag a marquee around those objects. Notice that it doesn't grab anything that it touches. You have to actually surround the objects with that marquee. Right click and then group again, and now it acts just as one piece. So we've changed our color down here. Okay, I'll just use the wheel to scroll out just a little bit right here. Click outside to deselect that. So now click on a state right down here. Let's do a copy and paste on this, and I'll do it up here from the menu. Edit copy, and then edit paste, and it comes right back in on top of the previous thing that we copied. So I'll use the up arrow, and I can just roll that up like that and get that above that house. And then let's just double click. Just click outside here someplace. There we go. There it is, and I'll type in Tri-Valley. Reselect that, and again, using the cursor keys, the arrow keys, I'm going to move this over here to the left-hand side so it lines up nicely above everything. So there's our basic logo. Using that graphic again, this was downloaded using the Connect content. Okay, roll back out again. Let's now put a picture. Let me just adjust. There we go. Let's put a picture now over here. I'm going to change the view on this. Just click here to the zoom tool, and let's choose fit to height, and that just maximizes the image. There we are. Okay, that's to put an image in here. Now I have one. We can import file and import, and I have one right here. And I have the same image. There's a link for this, and you can then download this image if you want to get a matching image. Again, it comes in too large, as you can see. Once more, I'll use the wheel on the mouse to roll back out on this one. Let's just bring this down in size quite a bit. It'll be about in here someplace. Let's right click, and again, we're going to change the order on this one and to back a page. Click outside, and then we'll zoom in a bit. Now I want to have this in a circle. We can do that very easily. I'm going to take this and just get it out of the way just for a second. I'm going to push over here off the page. Notice how you can work on things on your page and also have things outside of your page. If I scroll out a bit, there's our paper size right there. You can have a lot of stuff out here in the artboard area, things that you're working with. They won't print. Only anything inside here will actually print. So you can store things out here while you're working on them. Okay, let's go ahead and zoom back in again. And I'll go to the ellipse tool right here. And I'll come right about here. Come into about this spot right in here, about centered in there. Hold the shift key down, draw us in the center. Hold the control key down as well. And it gives you a perfect circle. So I'll just go about this big. And there's our circle. Now to put the image inside the circle, here's something which we haven't looked at yet. I'll go over here to the image. Just pull this in. I grabbed the wrong thing there. Let's just leave that alone. Okay, back over to our image. And I'll pull this about where I want it. And the size looks good, actually, so we're okay on the size. Now the photograph is selected, so go up here to Object and come down here where it says power clip and choose place inside frame. This is a kind of a little arrow you have there. Come down to an object, we want to have this circle here. Just click at that circle. It then takes that photo and puts it inside of that circle. That's a power clip. Be doing more with that in later discussions. Okay, that's all looking pretty good. We now want to have our blue swoop in here, so let's just scroll down just a little bit. For that, I'll grab the ellipse again, and I'll start over here someplace, and let's just pull an ellipse like that and pull it down a bit, and that gives us that nice swoop right in there. We can fill this in by left-clicking on our blue color, and that fills it in. The right-click, if we want to do that, that would change that outline. I'll leave that outline in there, and then that's our fill. Now it's in front of everything, so let's right-click, order, and to backup page. Now I don't want to have this stuff outside here. We can trim that off using a trim trick in here. Let's just, again, use the wheel, zoom out just a little bit. I'll go and grab the rectangular tool here, and then I'll come right down here to the bottom corner approximately, and let's just make a rectangle that's the same size as the page. Just right to those dotted lines, little dashed lines in there. There we go. Let's now click on the ellipse. Hold the shift key down and click on that rectangle we just drew. That selects both of those. And now up here, we have all kinds of different options. We have a combine, a weld, trim, intersect, simplify, front minus back, back minus front, and also a create boundary. For right now, what we want is this one. We'll come back and talk more about these options in a later video. But for right now, you want this one right here. It's called intersect. Click on that one, and notice how we now have that piece as its own separate object. We can now click on the ellipse, hit the delete key and get rid of that. Click on the rectangle, hit the delete key and get rid of that one. And then click on this object right here. And let's now click on our blue again, left mouse click, and then puts that fill back in again. Of course, it's in front of everything, so right click, order, and backup page. Okay, so far so good. We have this little line going right in there. We need to fix that bit. So let's click on this, right click, and order, front of page. So that's now in the very front, in front of that line. Okay, last thing to do is to work on our name up here. This time I'll just grab the text tool. There it is. And select your text just by clicking and dragging to select it. Just do a couple of things in here. I'm going to change this to a bold typeface and click on white, make it white. And then click off again. And then back to the pick tool. Last little thing is to change our position here. And let's just click outside and then right on the letter in there. And then just use the up arrow and let's reposition that a little bit in here to fit better on the page. There you go. A fast little business card. I left everything else at its default positions, of course. We could change the text in here, change the, you know, what it says, all that kind of stuff if you wanted to. But it's a real basic and fast little business card. Using a couple of new tricks in here with our cutting of that object in behind there and this little bit of putting one object inside of another and so forth. Of course, we used our clip art right down there. We'll be looking at all this stuff in greater detail in later discussions. But a nice little fast practice project here. Let's just do one last little thing. Click on the zoom tool. Go to fit to height, and there it is.